Vinjeru Trust School, learning together to grow in wisdom.
Learning together to grow in wisdom.
Mr. Monefe, teacher of mathematics here at Vinjeru Trust School. Joining the grade eight mathematics. That is our first topic in the series is ratio and the proportion. In our lesson today, we take out ratios. And about ratios, we're going to look at how to simplify ratios. And by the end of this lesson, I want you to be able to simplify any given ratio. So, ladies, wherever you are, follow me closely and pay particular attention. What is a ratio? A ratio is simply the comparison of two or more quantities of the same kind, that is, quantities in the same unity of measure. If it's meters, meters, kilometers, kilometers. If they are different, then you have to convey it. Remember, there's that common song you used to sing as you were growing up, that is composition. So the word I'm taking out there is composition, where you are comparing items or quantities. In the actual sense, that word is not composition, but comparison. So the second bullet there, we are saying if A and B are the quantities of the same units, then the ratio of A to B is expressed in that form, or can also be expressed as a fraction. If you're expressing a ratio as a fraction, take the first quantity as the numerator, like you can see there, and the second quantity as the denominator. Note that the ratios are expressed in their lowest form, and they have got no units. So next, let's look at this picture. In our picture here, we have got a group of seven students. Out of the seven students, we can draw the following ratios. That is, the first ratio, we can compare boys to girls. How do we compare boys to girls here? It's not about their height or their complexion, but it's about the number. How many boys do we have? So we can say B to G, to mean boys to girls. So how many boys do we have here? We have got, that is 1, 2. So we have got 2 boys. Since there are 7 in a group, if we take out 2, the rest is the number of girls, which is 5. So the ratio of boys to girls in this picture is 2 to 5. The other way around, let's compare girls to boys. That is G to B. So we are comparing here the number of girls to the number of boys in this group. So since we are saying we have got 5 and 2 boys, hence our ratio will be 5 to 2. If you look at the two ratios, they are already in their simplified form, in their lowest form, so we can't work them out further. So that becomes the final answer, and also here this becomes the final answer. Let's look at the other examples which we have. Simplifying ratios. Example. Simplify each of the following ratios here. Part A. If you look at the first ratio presented here, it's a ratio involving constants. So for such ratios, you simply go out simplifying them. How do you simplify? Look for the highest common factor. This is one way in which you are going to find simplifying ratios easy. So in this case, what is the highest common factor of 30 and 45? So you find that the largest value that is exactly divisible by 30 and 45 is 15. So we are going to divide both by 15. So that is, how many times can 15 go into 30? Remember, we are saying this is exactly divisible. So if that is 2 there, you are right. Then 15 into 45, which gives us 3. Hence, our answer becomes 2 to 3. So 30 to 45 as a simplified ratio gives us 2 to 3. Then the other example there, 2 kg to 800 grams. This case needs attention. It's different from the first case that we had here. In our case here, we have got units of different measure. So in this case, you need to convert. Remember, these terminologies can be barriers in our progression if we don't understand them. So breaking down the term convert simply means to change. So change either to kilometers, change either to kilograms or to grams. That is, your ratio should be in the same unity of measure. So let's change the kg to kilogram so that we see what we obtain. So we say 1 kg is equivalent to, that is 1000 grams. Then what about 2 kg? So our 2 kg will be equivalent to the unknown. So the unknown mass there will be represented by the variable x. Then we're going to do the mathematics by cross multiplying. So if we multiply x by 1, we'll obtain x there as a product. Then 1 over 2 multiplied by 1000, that gives us 2000. Remember, boys and girls here, we are converting to grams. So this gives us 2000 grams. So we are going to say 2000 grams, which is 2 kg, sorry, is equivalent to, compared to 800 grams. So we simplify it in this lowest term. So we're going to cancel out. Remember, we said ratios have got no units in our introduction. Then we also cancel out corresponding zeros there. So what it means there is equivalent to 8. Then don't forget your accuracy. Show your equal signs there to mean our main ratio there, our main presentation is equal to the breakdown steps that we are making there. Then it's not to end the last or the simplified the ratio from that. No. So that is, you need to simplify it further. Highest common factor. What's the highest common factor of 20 and 8? So that's the 4. Very good. So 4 into 20 gives us 5. Good. And then 4 into 8 is a 2. Wonderful. So our simplified answer now becomes 5 to 2. So 2 kg to 800 grams is just the same as 5 to 2. So boys and girls, this is very simple. Just take your time and be patient. Go through time and again so that you have the concept in you. Let's see what you can do at your own time now. So we go through the questions that I have prepared for you in this activity. Thank you for joining me. We'll compare our answers in my next lesson as we meet. Actually, not so part of that lesson. So in our next lesson as we meet. Thank you very much for your time.
You can contact us on 0969576072 or 0977671136 or email us at principal@vinjeruschooltrust.org. Visit us on Facebook, Vinjeru School Trust, or at our website www.vinjeruschooltrust.org. Vinjeru Trust School.